This video is going to cover several techniques that professional piano players use. Cocktail pianists, jazz pianists, pop pianists, we almost all use these same basic techniques. Then we add on to them the more we study and the more we play over the years, but this is basic stuff that we all use. This video picks up and continues where I left off in another video called The Five Basic Jazz Chords. Now in that video I talk about how these five basic chords, major 7, dominant 7, minor 7, minor 7, flat 5, and diminished, how they don't sound so good in a very root stock position. I'll be showing you several different things you can do with the chords. In this next segment here, I'm going to be showing you how to play just open sevenths in your left hand. So you're not defining the chord at all really, you're just playing an open seventh, so it could be a dominant 7 or a minor 7 or a minor 7 flat 5. You put a major 7 on there, then it's defined as a major 7. But this is a good technique for kind of faking it. Also, if you don't know your chords real well yet, then you just want to get through certain passages, you can just play the open seventh, and it sounds great. What we're going to do is play in our left hand only intervals of a seventh, whether it be a major 7 or a flatted 7. And we're going to find out that this works for all of these chords in MISTI. As a matter of fact, it'll work for almost all the chords you'll ever encounter in jazz standards. So what this means, the interval of a major 7, if we look at the E flat, it's just one step below the octave. There's the major 7 interval. If we're going to play the flatted 7 interval, or we can call it the dominant 7 or the minor 7 interval, flatted 7 interval, it's going to be this one here. This is for an E-flat chord. So we can do this on any one of our chords. We have the A-flat here. A-flat, if we want a major 7, we come down one half step from the octave. And if we want to play a minor 7 to fit this chord, minor 7 interval is going to be, looks like this. The D-flat is going to look like this, one step below the octave. That's one way to look at it. The other way is to look at it as if it's a full chord and you're just going to play the outside of it. Now this depends on how adept you are at making chords or spotting them and seeing them. But this is the other way. You would have the full chord here and you would just leave the two notes out of the middle and play the outside of the chord. Same thing on the B flat minor 7. We would just leave the two notes out of the middle and have this minor 7 interval or E flat. The two notes out of the middle, and so forth. So you can look at this two ways, depending on how familiar you are with making chords. So what we're going to do is play only this in our left hand, just these intervals of either major 7 or a flatted 7. And we're going to play the melody in the right hand and get a very pleasant sound. The interval of a 7th, a major 7 or a flatted 7, gives us a very pleasant dissonance that fills up a lot of space, and it creates a very nice sounding jazz sound. And when we add the melody to it, it sounds like this. So here I'm playing it in a very simple fashion, not giving it any rhythm, so to speak. I'm just playing the melody and a chord that would go with it. There's a major 7 interval in the left hand. Minor 7 in the left hand. Dominant 7 interval in the left hand. Major 7 in the left hand. Minor 7. Again, a minor 7 interval. Back to the major 7 interval, flatted 7 interval, flatted 7 intervals, flatted 7 interval, flatted 7 interval, flatted 7 interval, flatted 7 interval. Sometimes I say flatted 7 or minor 7 or dominant 7 interval. These are all synonymous. They just mean the smaller sevenths. Okay, let's give some rhythm to these left-hand technique ideas. We're going to go back to the interval of the seventh again and give it a straight quarter note pulse. Now you'll hear old swing players doing this a lot of times. Shearing is very famous for this. When you listen to his playing, It's just a straight ahead pulse, and I'm just going to use either the major 7 or the flatted 7 interval. So it's going to sound like this, 2, 3, 4. Just the intervals of a 7. You can hear the small 7, major 7, small 7. Right through like that, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, now I'll just put a melody to it, single note, and keep this pulse going in my left hand. I'm intentionally not putting any of our flourishes in the right hand just to show you how it can work like that, just very simply. It's kind of a nice light cocktail kind of a feel to it. Now this can be done at any tempo. Let me pick it up with a little more sprightly feel to it. So you can see just the same feel, you're just applying this pulse and putting a little more liveliness to it. And then if you loosen it up and if you get more comfortable with your right hand with the melody and making up some little improv, it can sound like this. 2, 3. And so forth.